Hi guys, my name is Sarah and I'm going to be showing you how to do a site inspection of Hotel Verde, Africa's greenest hotel. So, there are a couple of things that you really need to remember before going on your site inspection. Number one, don't forget to take your key card and check that it's still working. Sometimes if you put it with the phone, it won't work anymore. So make sure that if you need to, you recut it beforehand. The other thing you have to do is ask reception for the site inspection room beforehand. So I really like to show an open purple room, but sometimes that's not always available. So just make sure you know your room type, you have your room number, you have your key card before you go on the site inspection. The other thing to remember is to wear your name badge. And if you have a blazer, don't forget to wear that too, just so you look extra smart. Before you start your tour, just make sure that you ask your guests if they have any time constraints or if they have any specific interests that they would really like to see. We've also created a really comprehensive script and some cue cards for you to follow during your site inspection. Don't worry if you can't remember everything, rather keep your site inspection cue cards with you and refer to them if there are any questions. So the way the video has been filmed is so that you can imagine as though you're the one doing the site inspection. So forget about my boring voice and imagine that you're the one speaking while doing all those visuals and learning that information. If there's any questions you can't answer, don't feel embarrassed, don't feel ashamed. The information is complex and vast. So just make note of it and get back to the guest at a later stage.
Welcome to your tour of Africa's greenest hotel. Thank you for taking the time to join us and find out just what makes Hotel Verde the greenest hotel on the continent. Before we begin our tour today, I'd like to take some time to tell you about the history of the hotel. Owners Mario and Anna Marie Delicio opened the hotel in August 2013. The name Verde, meaning green in Italian, took its heritage from owner Mario. He was born in Italy and grew up in Germany where he met his wife Anna Marie. They then moved to South Africa where they raised their three children. The mandate from the Delicio family to the design team was always to build Africa's greenest hotel. They wanted to prove that luxury and sustainability do not have to be mutually exclusive. The sustainability measures at the hotel are holistic in nature and they go far beyond what meets the eye. Some of these touch points we will cover on your tour today. As a four-star hotel, we really have proven that comfort and going green can go hand in hand. We are the only hotel in the entire world to be certified LEED Platinum for both our design and construction, as well as our operations and maintenance. We have displayed our certificates on the wall in our reception, as well as on the plaque on the wall outside. LEED stands for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. It's a third-party certification from the United States Green Building Council, of which platinum is the highest rating. It is considered to be the premier mark of accomplishment for green buildings worldwide. It provides us and our guests with third-party verification that the hotel was built and continues to operate as sustainably as possible. You can find more information on the LEED certifications on our website. We're also the first hotel on the African continent to offer what is called a carbon neutral hotel experience. This means that guests who stay and conference with us do so with absolutely no impact to the environment. We offset the carbon emissions of our guests by purchasing certified carbon credits that go towards benefiting a socially responsible environmental project in the Lake Kariba area in Zimbabwe. This focuses on issues such as reforestation, sustainable farming, gender parity, and job creation. Whilst we pass through the sliding doors, you can take the time to look at your cabinet to the right-hand side. We have been very fortunate to have won a number of local and international awards, for which we are both humbled and very proud. Some of these awards include the World's Best City Hotel for Responsible Tourism, which we won at World Travel Market London, and the Company Trendsetter Award, which we won at Internorga in Hamburg, Germany. We were also very happy to earn a number of local awards, such as the Enviropedia Awards, for our energy and water-saving efforts. This takes us to the wind turbines, the iconic landmark that marks the hotel as a green building before one even enters the premises. These wind turbines showcase Hotel Verde's commitment to renewable energy generation. About 11% of the hotel's total energy demand is met by renewable energy. In fact, Hotel Verde generates enough of its own electricity to power 215 mid-income households in Cape Town in a year. What makes the wind turbines different is the fact that they are vertical axis. This means that the axis of rotation stands vertically and the blades spin around that. The wind turbines are each installed at 3 kilowatts. A kilowatt is a unit of power, which describes the rate at which energy is generated. Each of these turbines is able to power 2 household geysers when at maximum output. If you turn to face the hotel, you will see the vegetative roof on the first floor. This not only looks aesthetically pleasing and is good for the holistic biodiversity of the hotel, but it also has an energy efficiency component. This is because it provides insulation to the reception below, therefore reducing the need for heating and cooling in the reception and reducing the overall amount of energy that is needed. Over here you can see the split bins, which are located in public and back of house areas. Waste management is a really big part of the hotel's green philosophy. We have a goal of zero waste to landfill. That means we really want to avoid 100% of our waste from reaching landfill sites. Waste management does, however, start at procurement level, where you are able to make better procurement decisions based on type and amount of packaging. Therefore, this common reduce, reuse, recycle should really come with a predecessor, rethink. We also have an on-site waste separation site where we manage our waste through recycling and composting. We have both bokashi and vermicomposting on site. Bokashi means fermented organic matter in Japanese. It uses a bran powder to decompose food waste to turn into compost. Vermicompost is the product of using worms to decompose food into high-quality compost. In order to achieve staff engagement with waste, each day a different member of staff, all the way up to management, is rostered in the waste area. This ensures that all duties in the waste area are carried out together with the dedicated waste managers.
So at this stage, you either have the option to explain the entire waste management concept, or you can ask the guest if they have time and have a specific interest in looking at the waste recycling facility. If they do, why not show it to them? We're all about transparency.
Over here, we've got our grey water recycling plant. Here we recycle the water from about 80% of the showers and baths and use it for the flushing of our toilets. This saves about 6,000 litres of water per day and means that we never flush drinking water in our toilets at the hotel. In a year, we are able to save the same amount of water that would fill 6.5 Olympic swimming pools. The water in the plant is mechanically and biologically filtered and sterilized through the series of tanks you see here. What adds to our water saving efforts is the fact that we only have 8 baths in the hotel. There is also a secret bath ban, and reservations will only allocate a room with a bath if need be.
If you have very little time for your site inspection and the guest has, say, only 15 minutes, forget going to the gym. It's going to take way too long. Rather explain what makes the gym special from here.
To your left, you can see the beautiful mosaic art piece that was installed by artist Jocelyn de Freitas. This is a great indication of the importance we have placed on art in the hotel. As we walk through, you will see that it is saturated in beautiful art by local South African artists. All of these art pieces, in some way or another, communicate an environmental or social message. Take the mosaic, for example. It displays the different earthly resources that we harness or conserve to be more sustainable. Wind, water, sun, and even the ground, which in just a few minutes you will see exactly how we utilize to be more energy efficient.
Oh, she can wait for what I can give. She knows what I am, but she won't believe me. Is it all okay? Will I come off the light? This I give it,
it's always like this. You see those square-shaped holes? It's not the builder that ran out of bricks. Those are intentionally placed natural ventilation shafts to naturally pick up exhaust fumes and vent them out of the building using no electricity. There are also electric fans which are linked to 5 carbon monoxide sensors. These activate fans when the concentration of fumes is too high. Our basement certainly is one of the most beautiful and interesting basements around the world. This beautiful wraparound graffiti that you see here was commissioned through an artist by the name of Harun Gansali. He's now become a very well-known South African artist. He worked with 4 muralists from the Cape Flats to create these beautiful pieces of art using only spray cans and not one paintbrush. The paint used is low VOC, which stands for low volatile organic compound. This means that the paint is non-toxic and does not emit any of those nasty chemicals that are harmful to us. In fact, all paints and adhesives in the hotel are low VOC. This drastically improves the air quality of the building, in turn meaning a healthier space for both employees and guests. Over here is the massive 40,000 litre stainless steel water storage tank, where we store all of our collected rain and subsoil drainage water. This water is then used for irrigation, car washing, and the cleaning of hard surfaces. This is a Kobiak's void former. It is a recycled polypropylene hollow ball that was used during the construction to displace concrete. About 46,000 void formers were used in total, which were placed in the 5 floor slabs before concrete was poured. This managed to avoid the use of about 1,279 tons of concrete, or 34% of the 5 floor slabs, all while still maintaining the building's structural integrity. This made the building lighter, eliminating the need for transfer beams, which you can see here in the basement. One can also consider that avoiding the use of this concrete had an entire life cycle effect. We were then able to avoid the carbon associated with the production as well as the transportation of this concrete. Now we are entering the heart of the hotel, the plant room. As you might have noticed, our technical installations are easily visible for our guests. This is because education is a very important focus of the hotel and provides a platform to engage guests in some of the more technically sustainable aspects of the hotel. Usually, a plant room is a bland and dark area where no one from the public will venture, whereas we have ensured that even our brand colors are carried into this room. A normal hotel would have a boiler for hot water, a chiller for aircon, and if you're lucky, heat pumps for heating. Each of those require electricity and have their own waste products. In our case, we have one integrated system which is used for heating, cooling, and hot water. This system relies on these 4 heat pumps over here, as well as the geothermal field. The heat pumps themselves work very similarly to a fridge. In the case of a fridge, warmth is removed from the inside to keep the food cold, but this warmth has to travel somewhere, and so it gets moved to the back radiator pipes, which then get warm. In our case, the heat pumps work very similarly. They take warmth out of the cooling water, which then gets colder and used for air conditioning. They move the warmth into the heating water, which gets hotter and is used for heating and to make hot water. The problem is, depending on the season, there is usually an imbalance, and there will always be more need to cool in summer and more need to heat in winter. That's where the geothermal field comes in. So, before the foundation was built, 100 boreholes were drilled about 65 meters deep into the ground. Pipes were inserted that go all the way to the bottom, bend back up to the top. These 100 sets of pipes were then connected together to make a total of 13 kilometers worth of piping underground. In summer, when we need to use more cooling, we have leftover hot water. This water is then circulated through these 13 kilometers of pipes, where it dumps heat into the ground, and comes back into the plant room cooler, thereby restoring the imbalance. In winter, it's exactly the opposite. This makes our heating and cooling system extremely energy efficient. This screen is the control panel for the plant room. When running, you can observe the temperature going into the geothermal field and the new temperature coming out of it. The screen connects to the hotel's building management system, which is used to monitor consumption of water and power, as well as the correct running of systems and equipment. What makes our building management system especially special is that it notifies the maintenance team when there is a problem that needs addressing, such as a blocked filter, for example, or the need for a PV panel to be cleaned. Over here, you can see the signage which marks a preferential spot for vehicles that carpool. Carpooling is not only encouraged amongst our employees, but is also a really great way to reduce your emissions and make friends. Whilst I'm speaking about signage, this comes back to what I mentioned earlier to be a big priority for the hotel: education and knowledge sharing. Look out as we continue for all of the strategically placed signs that aim at educating our guests with an overview of the sustainable interventions we have put in place. Now we'll take a trip up to the first floor, and I hope you don't mind if we save energy and take the stairs. The gym at Hotel Verde is very special because it is home to Africa's first power generating gym equipment, namely the elliptical machine and the two recumbent bikes. The machines themselves are able to power very little energy, however they act more as an tool to engage guests with the idea that energy is very easy to squander and not so easy to generate. The What the What signage works as a way for guests to relate to the amount of energy they are able to produce into something relative, such as a 2-minute hot shower or a cup of coffee. This makes it far more understandable. The gym can also be used by public guests if they take up the freshening up facility rate from the hotel. This also includes the use of our change rooms, the outdoor area, business center, and Wi-Fi. All right, so you're in the gym and no one's been in here. So now what the best thing to do is to show the guest the daylight harvesting. All you have to do is point out at this sensor and the lights will switch on and switch off if there is enough light in the room. Perfect example of when a light is able to measure the lux levels in a room and then dim appropriately. Before the hotel opened, owners Mario and Anna Marie Delicio initiated and funded an art project whereby 45 learners from various schools were given the opportunity to research, conceptualize, and produce artworks in a variety of media. It was primarily Anna Marie's passion for art and social upliftment that brought about the project, with the hope to help students who have limited, if any, access to art studies at their schools. This was done by giving them the best tools, teachers, and facilities available to do what they love and what they're good at. The project was facilitated by the Frank Joubert Art Center in Newlands and driven by art consultant Nicholas Zimmer. The learners' finished artworks were then taken to local specialist crafters who took up to 3 months to turn the works into various final pieces, ranging from the mosaics to woven and beaded pieces which now adorn the passages of the hotel. So now we're going to go into
our
room.
Hey, what you doing?
Remember to knock.
As we enter the room, I would like to point out the key card. This activates the electricity in the room, ensuring lights are not left on when a guest is not in the room. This is an example of a standard open plan purple room. We have 145 rooms in total in the hotel, of which 130 are standard rooms. Our standard rooms have the option of an open shower such as this one, or a closed shower should you prefer more privacy. We also have 8 studio rooms, 2 universally accessible rooms, 4 executive rooms, which seat 4 people and have semi self-catering facilities, as well as 1 executive suite, which sleeps up to 6 and also has semi self-catering facilities. Our bedrooms are aimed at providing ultimate comfort and convenience. We have 300 thread count hypoallergenic linen. Some say we have the best beds in town. As mentioned earlier, the air quality in the bedrooms are better due to the use of low VOC paints, adhesives, and mirror mastics. We provide amenities in our bathrooms that are in reusable containers and contain ingredients that are not harmful to our guests or to the environment. All showers and taps have low flow fittings, which allow for the same feeling but with better functionality and more water saving capacity. As we have high volumes of international guests, we have international plug points for their convenience. If you take a look at the tea coffee station, you will also notice the small kettle. Many hotels have already taken to providing their guests with small kettles. However, what differentiates us further is the fact that we have educational signage which reminds our guests to only boil as much as they need. As a part of our local procurement plan, we try to support small businesses. A great example of this is how we supply our guests with biscuits. These are made by a lady by the name of Nazima. Initially, we provided her with the packaging for the biscuits and placed her cell phone number on the packaging so guests could order from her directly. She has since had to employ several more people in her business to keep up with this. Another great supplier story is one that demonstrates engagement from suppliers to also be more eco-friendly themselves. The coffee that we utilize in the rooms is a fair trade product. However, at first the packaging was going directly to landfill. So, in our pursuit to send less waste to landfill, we approached the supplier and asked them to make the packaging recyclable. So, they one-upped us by taking it further and ensuring that the package is not only recyclable, but also compostable. Many hotels ask guests to reuse their towels, but we decided that we wanted to give the guests the opportunity to be more eco-friendly and encourage them by making them the beneficiary of these choices. If our guests choose to be more eco-friendly, they will earn a Vedino. A Vedino is currently valued at 5 Rand and can be used in the hotel as real money. Here are some of the ways you can earn Vedinos as a guest. Reusing your towels, choosing not to utilize all of the pillows on the beds and leaving them aside with the rimmen intact for housekeeping. Separating your waste correctly in the marked bins, choosing not to use the air conditioning in the room, taking a turn on the power generating gym equipment, taking the stairs to a floor above the second floor, and using the jogging track. Instead of utilizing a conventional paper room directory, we have placed all of the hotel information as well as our sustainability information on an interactive TV. This includes the room service menu, which can be ordered 24 hours of the day. We also have an in-house sustainability channel, which displays live statistics of the environmental and financial savings of the hotel. I'm sure you've noticed that whilst on the tour, we have not heard a single plane fly over, despite being only 400 meters from the airport. This is largely attributed to the fact that we have double glazing on the windows. The double glazing, however, also has an energy saving component in reducing the heat load on the building.
So this is a really great opportunity to actually show the guest how the double glazing works. If you just open the window, you can definitely hear the difference.
It's been days now.
Whilst we are back in the reception area, I'd like to take the time to show you some of the interesting facts of this area. The beautiful wood panels that you see behind the reception desk are made of alien wood. This means that we have used wood from sources that are not local or indigenous to South Africa. We do this because we don't want to cut down indigenous trees, whilst alien trees need to be cut down because they are using up all of the resources such as water for our local trees.
That means there is also job creation in supporting the procurement of alien wood products. In front of the panels are the different time zone clocks, which display the hotel's corporate values. These are the values through which we aim to treat our colleagues as well as our guests. To my left, you can see our regenerative drive elevators. These save up to 30% of the energy that a conventional lift would use. We have a total of 3 of these in the building, and each lift has regenerative braking technology. This allows them to recover energy on their light cycles. This simply means that if the lift travels up and is empty, or travels down with a lot of people in it, it will generate electricity for the building. Imagine a rugby team taking the lift down from the 4th floor and running back up to the top to take the lift down again, just to produce energy for the building. Over here you've got the clothing bank. This gives guests the opportunity to donate any of the unwanted items. You can imagine that as an airport hotel, we often have guests who have done way too much shopping and need to offload some weight before getting on their flight. So, we offer them the opportunity to rather donate the excess baggage to a good cause. We then donate these clothes to the Night Haven shelter in Belleville. Over here, we have an international roaming bookshelf, where our guests are encouraged to rather reuse books than buy new ones. If a guest is willing to leave a book behind, he may then take one on his trip with him from the shelf. This is a small but great way to reduce emissions as an individual, because the average paperback book is equivalent to 4 kilograms of carbon. The music area and Kids Corner act as a great showcase that we are both a culturally and family-orientated hotel. We aim to be as child-friendly as possible, even going as far as to allow children under 12 to stay for free. The living wall is not only an attractive addition to the hotel's interior, but it also improves the interior air quality of the building by absorbing toxins and releasing oxygen. The plants are watered via drip irrigation whilst receiving sunlight from the skylight. Where there is no skylight, we have utilized LED grow lamps, which are on timers. And since they are purple, they're great for branding. This is the main conferencing area, where we have 7 conference venues that can cater anything from 2 to 120 delegates. All lights in the hotel are energy efficient LED lights. But public areas such as this one are a great example of where we have used motion sensors on our lights to ensure that if no one is in the area, the lights switch off automatically. The same goes for the carpets in highly tread areas such as this one, where we have used recycled tires as underfelt as opposed to conventional padding. As mentioned earlier, the conferencing that we offer is carbon neutral. What's great about this is that after a company conferences with us, they receive a carbon offset certificate stating the amount in kilograms they have offset personally. This is an auditable and trackable certificate that can be used directly for company sustainability and integrated reports. Along with state-of-the-art AV equipment, international plug points, and comfortable seating, we try to make our conferencing greener in a number of ways. Instead of making use of PET plastic bottles, we bottle all of our still and carbonated water on site. This avoids a great deal of unnecessary packaging, transportation of goods, as well as the water that is wasted in the conventional bottling process. All of our pencils, notepads are made from FSC certified recycled content, whilst all of our notepads are printed at a carbon neutral printer. We also put our notepads out of doodle reach. You'd be surprised how much paper this actually saves. As we pass the orange wall, go ahead and touch its rough exterior. This has been made utilizing recycled glass. This corner of the hotel is a fantastic demonstration of art as a communicator for environmental messaging. Over here you can see the beautiful upcycled art pieces by Barbara Wildenburg. this piece using old books, and this one using old clock mechanisms and maps. The idea behind this art piece is that the birds, like issues of climate change, are not confined by political and geographical borders. Perhaps that we need to rise above them and connect together as a global population to enforce change. If you look carefully, you can see that some of the clock mechanisms are going backwards. This kinetic art installation by Justin Fisk is not only a great talking point due to its interactive nature, but it is also a great example how one can create something beautiful and interesting with common objects that would usually be considered to have very little value. Welcome to Nuevo Restaurant and Bar. Nuevo meaning new in Italian. It's open not only to our in-house guests, but anyone who would like to stop over for a drink or meal. The bar is open until 1 a.m. 7 days a week. We have a number of craft beers on tap in attempt to support local microbreweries. The great thing about drinks on tap is that one can also avoid all forms of packaging waste. Our water is filtered and bottled in the back bar area. The wine cooling fridge is also a great example of smart use of design. The HVAC, or our aircon unit, runs through the section of the fridge that stores the red wines. This means that no additional electricity is needed to cool the red wines and keep them at that perfect drinking temperature. Over here you can see our menus. These are special due to the fact that they are made out of the wood pallets that came from the crates that the regenerative drive elevators were delivered in. A really great example of upcycling. Here is our suppliers board. We try our best to source our consumables from small, local suppliers as close by as possible. The LEED certification stipulates that you should get a certain percentage of your consumables within 160 kilometers of the hotel. We also want to be transparent with our guests about exactly where their products are coming from. This is why we display it on this board. This falls in line with our operational materials management plan, which guides the procurement at the hotel. We aim to ensure that all products tick the following boxes: better for the guest, better for the community, better for the environment, and better for the hotelier. Our breakfast is served from 4:30 in the morning, perfect for guests who have an early flight. Every Wednesday evening, we host an Earth Hour event, where we switch off all unnecessary lights and appliances. Guests dine to solar and candlelight, and we have a live band that entertains our guests while a specially selected menu is available that uses no electricity to prepare. This is our vertical aquaponics unit, where we grow plants such as lettuce, herbs, spinach, leeks, peppers, tomato, and spring onions. Fish can be found in the water tanks at the base of the system. This is what differentiates it between a typical hydroponic unit, making it an aquaponic unit. The fish feed on the algae growing in the tanks, as well as small amounts of additional food. The nutrient of the fish waste, once broken down by a biofilter, feeds the plants. We harvest the plants and regrow on a constant basis, replanting about every 3.5 months. The aquaponic system allows for virtually emission-free, cost-effective, sustainable food production, and it's a high-density per floor area, saving water in comparison to traditional planting methods. We are now at our beautiful eco pool, a natural pool that uses no salt, harmful chemicals, or sterilization. The water is kept sparkling clean by circulating it through a living ecosystem of aquatic plants. The result is water which is perfectly clean, soft on the skin, and better for our guests and the environment in comparison to conventional pools. If you turn around, you can see the northern facade of the building, where you can see 66 of the total 220 photovoltaic panels at the hotel. The rest can be found on the roof. We have strategically placed them on the northern side of the building due to the northern side receiving the most sun in the southern hemisphere.
What makes them even more special is the angle at which they have been placed to also provide shade to the rooms below. This reduces the heat load and reduces the need for air conditioning. The PV panels produce the most renewable energy, and that is a total of 9% of our energy demand at the hotel. At peak output, our PV panels can boil 26 kettles at one time. Just below the panels, you can see the YZ rain filter. The rainwater from about one third of the roof is captured and passed through the filter, which is self-cleaning. It uses centrifugal force to remove leaves and debris before channeling it into the 40,000 liter stainless steel tank you saw earlier in the basement. Prior to building the hotel, the wetland was slowly degrading. Wetlands are a very important part of biodiversity and are a life source for many communities, so it is very important that we maintain them. Passers-by were carelessly discarding refuse, businesses or contractors were dumping rubble from renovation, and the notorious Cape Town southeasterly wind really did not improve matters when copious amounts of packaging and dust were dumped into the fragile ecosystem. We approached the City of Cape Town and Airports Company of South Africa. They were open to the idea of placing the remote plots into the caring hands of our team. Now the two plots are joined, maintained, cleaned, landscaped, and beautified on an ongoing basis. What we did is planted over 100 types of indigenous or water-wise vegetation. We installed an eco trail and two beehives, which now house over 60,000 Cape honeybees. There is also an outdoor gym for our guests to enjoy. The area has now become a green lung in the airport industrial precinct for all passers-by or hotel guests to enjoy.
So guys, that concludes your site inspection training video. I hope you found it really informative. Don't forget to thank your guests, ask them if they have any other questions, but I know that you're going to make the hotel really, really proud. But did we also explain, Carin, the leadership, critical access, speed? They are able to provide that much energy. That is wrong. In the guise of, we'll do that again.
Take number 500.
1 million. Okay. I mustn't point to the Sorry. It has a carbon footprint of about 4 foot.
Keep going.
What are they called again? Grown-ups. Making your conference a real cinch. Our purchased. Making our conference carbon neutral offsets. No, okay. Practicessor. That's not right either. This is the hardest thing to explain there. This, with my presentations as well. Should I say that thing about making it extra special? I mean,
okay.